Today we're going to demonstrate how to apply power to the new JENEsys Edge 534 by Lynxspring, as well as an Onyxx XM when they're working together. To apply power, first you need to have a dedicated power supply for the Edge 534 and XM or Onyxx XM. If you need power for other things, you need to provide a separate power supply for those items as well. The JENEsys Edge 534 controller and the Onyxx XM IO module accept both 24 volts AC and DC. From the labels on each unit, you can see from left to right we have ground, power, common. Again on the Edge 534, ground, power, and common. To apply the power, we use this three terminal block. I'll pull it out, and for our purposes here, I've already pre-wired it. Again, the wires I'm using are 16 gauge, and I use this 3/32 slotted screwdriver. Worked pretty well. So you want to tighten those down, plug it in. Generally it'll click, you'll know it's in. We do the same with the Onyxx XM. All right. Now we have power applied at both places. Again, just a reminder, using a dedicated power supply. Now, to get the Edge 534 to communicate with the Onyxx XM, we use these gray terminals. That is our Onyxx network. The Onyxx network is indicated on the label by LXH, LXL, and Shield. Is priority sensitive, and for our cases I have pre-wired a cable to do exactly what we need to do. Okay, on Onyxx XM we can see we have an end-of-line resistor here, but we do not on the Edge 534. However, there is one internal, so we have both ends of the network terminate with the end-of-line resistor. Now we'll apply power. The power lights are constantly on and the heartbeats go through a series of beats, and finally when the station is running a double beat will be indicated here